and an adventure 65 million years in the making, here's your look at the Factory Entertainment Jurassic Park REVOs. REVOs spin, they rock, and wobble. They're the revolutionary new lineup of vinyl figures. We'll be having a look at the Jurassic Park Wave 1, consisting of a Raptor, Ian Malcom, and Alan Grant. Just before I get these guys measured off, a big thank you, by the way, to Factory Entertainment for providing these samples. If you guys are interested in picking these ones up for yourself, you can find them over on Factory Entertainment's website. I'll provide the link down below. So we're going to go ahead and measure off these. They're on average about the same height. Obviously, the Raptor's a little bit shorter. Alan Grant is 4.7 inches in height, which works out in centimeters to be rather impressive, 12.1 centimeters for, again, their height. I'll also measure off the Raptor, because the Raptor is a little bit smaller. Let's go ahead and get that tape measure reset. And right to the very top of the Raptor's head, stopping right there, the REVOs of the Raptor stands at 4.1 inches in height, which in centimeters works out to be 10.4 centimeters tall. Yeah, so you can currently get the sets over on Factory Entertainment's website for a price point of $39. And you get your set of figures here. They have also produced, something of which we will be looking at in the next review, a horror lineup of REVOs between Jurassic Park and horror property characters done in this REVOs style. I'm really super, super excited for these. Now, the REVOs actually kind of reminds me of something I had as a kid. Probably some of you probably also remember things like this as kids. Remember, I think they were called Weebos, where they would be basically self-correcting characters that had rounded bottoms to them. And while these ones don't have necessarily rounded bottoms, they can certainly say at the very least they have rounded bases. This self-correcting mechanism that they put inside allows the REVOs to basically wobble, teeter, and totter, but they never fall over. I think actually the Weebles, that was their trademark as well. They weeble and they wobble, but they won't fall down, I think was the actual tagline. So again, these are very similar in that, other than for the fact that the base is really what the rounded correcting mechanism is. The characters are then standing perched atop of these bases. So like, for example, Alan Grant's got, as you can see there, the imprinted footprint done here in a almost like a muddy terrain. He is standing and holding a torch in his hand, hopefully drawing the attention of the T-Rex that's coming near to them right now. A very simplified looking kind of mold to them. They kind of look like they're animated versions of the characters from the movie. All the coloring, though, is accurate to how they looked in the film, if not for the fact that they do look a little bit more cartoony. The characters do not come off of their base. They are affixed to them, so you can't take them off. But a really nice looking Alan Grant. Again, if you like that super stylized look. The selling point, of course, for these is the fact that they have the weebling action, the REVOs action. We'll move over to Ian here, because I really want to save the Raptor for the last. Now, Ian Malcom, again, is standing atop of a display stand, but it's not really quite the same stand as Alan Grant's. You can see here, it is kind of looks like a fossil that they've done on the bottom here, done in blue, a contrast to the brown for Alan's display base. They've got him in his trademark suit. It's a nice additional color that's been added there to his belt. Also there, he's got some additional gray that's added to his sleeve. Again, it looks like Ian Grant, if Ian Grant was just more of a kind of a caricature of himself. Much larger in the head, much smaller in the torso. A nice little accompanying touch that they put in there as well is the little cup of water. No ripples in there, but a cup of water nonetheless. Again, it has the same action as Alan Grant's, so you can tip them, you can knock them over somewhat. I mean, obviously, if they fully tilt over, then they'll fall. But for the most part, you can tip them, you can spin them, and they're always sort of correcting themselves, correcting their balances. Last but certainly not least is the Raptor. Hold on a second, let me just slow down. Hold on there, Ian. Don't get ahead of yourself. The last and certainly not least, probably my favorite of the batch here is the Velociraptor. Now, the Velociraptor here is done in some really nice coloring here, almost like a, I almost want to say like a chili pepper brown. That's a probably, almost like a coffee colored brown, very light coffee brown with a dark brown. I'm always trying to find food ways to describe colors. Failing miserably here to describe the Velociraptor. Hopefully the camera's doing a better job than I am to describe it. I don't know if deliberate, but I like that there's that breakup of color where you've got that brown, insert whatever color brown that is, and then you've got kind of a little breakup where you see a lighter color underneath there. The claws are done in black. They've finished off the nails there also in its claws like that. And again, a nice little head sculpt there for a little cartoon version of the Velociraptor. Now this one is standing on top of not quite the muddy terrain that Alan Grant would have, but certainly a, still a very much an outside landscape. I like also that they've sculpted in the feet so you can see as if the raptor has been walking across the terrain, and they've got a few little leaves on there as well. This one has a lighter colored base, while both Ian and Alan, as you can see, have the dark colored bases. Velociraptor instead has been relegated to the color, again, this sort of brownish orange color, a contrast to the greenish color that's located on the top there. Again, I really do like these. I like the fact that they teeter, they totter, they won't fall over. I gotta be careful, I'm actually not trademarking a Weebles tagline. But again, like these REVOs are really fun collectibles. Factory Entertainment has produced two versions of these right now. As it currently stands, I think they've only got the Jurassic Park, and then they've also got the horror ones. Both of which do excite me because I've always been a big fan of dinosaurs, and you know me, I'm also a big fan of horror figures. We're going to be having a look at the horror REVOs in the upcoming review. Normally, Factory Entertainment are known for producing TV and movie high-end replicas, recreating some of the cool gadgets and other things that we see in television and film. It's a nice departure for them, producing a nice little side collectible that you can pick up and display for yourself. Again, they've only produced, as far as I know, the Jurassic Park REVOs as well as the horror REVOs, both of which we will be looking at the next video. We will be looking at the horror REVOs. If you guys are interested in picking up either one of these, you can pick up the sets over right now at Factory Entertainment's website. The price point is $39 even, and usually they'll ship within 24 to 48 hours. If you want to add this one to your cart right now, you can head on over to Factory Entertainment's website and order today, as well as, of course, the ton of really cool replicas and collectibles that they're also selling over on their website. Today we were, thanks again to the folks over at Factory Entertainment, today we were having a look at the new Jurassic Park. This was the assortment of bobbling action REVOs. Trying my best not to recreate the ad from Weebles. They're sort of like Weebles, but just an adult version of Weebles. That's probably the best way I can describe it. Want to go back and have a look at some of my other Factory Entertainment reviews? There's a whole playlist just for Factory Entertainment. I've had a look at a couple of their collectible replicas as of right now. So if you guys want to see some of the stuff that I've done for them, feel free to head on over to the Factory Entertainment playlist. Check that out. And while you're also at it, like I said, if you haven't done so already, why not hit that little subscribe button down below? More videos will be coming soon to this channel, so stay tuned for those. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you next time.